I'll create a new fields from schema builder. Under which object I need to create? Pro coding skills.
Okay.
This is what I'm thinking to create. So now I'll go to elements.
Mm-hmm.
Here I'll say checkbox. Is active. Uncheck it, check. Okay. Save. Simple C. Just drag and drop. Currency. Currency, no. Number, email. Email. Save. Long text area. Details. Save. Date, start date. Date. Four. Content for it. This is just a random field that I am creating, okay?
So this is another way of creating field?
Yes.
Okay, this seems to be very easy.
Now you don't decide by seeing it, just a cover.
Okay.
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 Status. Draft. Validation. Pending for approval. Approve. Publish. Rejected. Okay. We created fields. Okay. Simple fields. And I'll refresh here. I don't get anything. But okay. It is having in setup. It's there in setup now.
Okay.
So we should not take a decision by seeing that what is easy, what is not.
Okay.
Pro coding skills, fields and relationship. We have a fields here, right?
Yeah.
But which is not available in this place. The particular field area, whatever you are seeing, this page, this is called page layouts.
Okay.
Now here you have a page layout.
Okay.
Here, open this page layout. Open this page layout and add your information like section. I'm adding one section. Contact information. Here we have detail page and edit page. I'm saying two columns. Okay.
Okay.
And then
okay.
Email, phone, and account details is something I'll say here. Okay. And here I'll add my blank space. And then contact information, course information. Course information, sessions, these are like a headers part, content URL, start date, end date, is active, status, and details is something I can't add here, and I'll put a blank here, and I'll go to here. More information. I don't want two columns because this is a field. So one column field, and I'll just put one column. Okay, it have a complete occupancy now.
Okay.
Save. So because we added to page layout, right?
Yeah.
We should get here. No, it will not. It will not come. But the problem here is still there is an issue, but because you are a system administrator, you got it. So ideally what happens, if I go to content URL, you can go to field level security. If you can see, it is only available for all users. Okay, all standard users, it got it by default. Clear, then fine. Generally, you don't get it, the options in if you are creating for a first time, okay? These are the standard profiles which we got it. Otherwise, we need to go to profiles and we need to enable to the users, field level security. Clear?
Yeah. Okay.
Now, when I make email, as soon as I enter my start date and end date, okay, start date and end date, and if I say content is approved, if I say content is approved or rejected or validations or anything, right? In draft, I don't want to send an email. In validation, I don't want to send an email. Pending for approval, I don't want to send an email. As soon as it get approved or published or rejected, any of these three status, we need to send an email to users. We need to send an email to users saying that, hey, the content has been in the pro coding skills has been published to the mail ID which was provided here. Clear?
Yeah.
When we need to do, whenever we select the status, right?
Yes.
Okay. Let me get a details from you only. So what's the start date? I'll just provide 18. And end date, I'll say 24th. The content URL www.procodingskills.com. And what's your email?
Nikhil, N-I-K-H-I-L.
N-I-K-H-I-L.
Dot. J-I-T-H-A.
J?
I-T-H-A at gmail.com.
Okay. So this is, I'm making this active. This is a random check. So I'm saving this information. Now it's in pending for approval, okay? Now we got, so what I need to do, we need to create a workflow rule. Whenever the status is approved or rejected, we need to send an email. Now the problem comes here. If I want to send an email, how I wanted to send an email? I want to send an email saying that, hi, content name. Content name is Inukurti Lakshmi Deepak. Hi, Inukurti Lakshmi Deepak. Your content has been in this status. So, your content has been updated to status equal to and the value which we selected there for the start date and end date and by providing a basic details like account details, okay?
Okay.
So, now, if I want to do in a school days, right, whenever you are writing a letter, we'll be having a template. Right? Blueprint.
Yes.
In Salesforce also, we need to have the template ready first. We need to create our template first, then we can create the emails. Okay?
Okay.
Now, to create a template, we have a concept called email templates. We have a concept called classic email templates. Classic email templates. First, what I'll do, I'll create a new folder.
Okay.
You are following my navigation?
Yes, yes.
Yeah. Here we have a new folder. Create new folder.
Folder.
So I'm creating a new folder and the folder name is Pro Coding Skills Content Emails. Pro Coding Skills Content. Why I'm saying, whenever I'm relating to this particular object, I'll have that folder so that it would be very easy for me to understand.
Okay.
Public access is reader, right, that I'm providing. So I don't want to choose any. These are the sample templates provided by Salesforce that I don't want to choose anything to this folder. This folder is accessible by all users. Yes, I will say for now, this is available for all users and I'm saving it. Now I'll create a new template. Now the folder I selected is pro coding skills content. I'm creating a new template. So I'm just, we have four different templates, Nikhil. One is text type, is a plain text. HTML in the sense using letter. Whenever you are getting, if you go to the hospital and somewhere, they will be having their name at top and bottom, their contact information, header and footer.
Yes.
So if you want to build something like this, you have to use HTML. Our custom is something without letterhead. So you can have that word, block letters, or plain letters and all this okay. stuff. And Visual Force is something like a complex email template. So if you need to get information on certain basic conditions, then you need to write a custom Visual Force pages to do this. This involves coding.
Okay.
But now we are using a text as a simple type. Next. Now here you can see the folder you can change even now. These are the available folders, three folders. I'm choosing folder called Pro Coding Skills. We can change it, no issues, right?
Okay.
And you need to look into this field. Whenever you check this, then only this email template is available to send emails. Otherwise, it will not be.
Okay.
Status update notification. Status update notification is my email template name. What is the subject? Your content has been modified. Your content has been modified. Status has been modified. Right? Something we are sending a subject, email subject like this. So what okay. we decided, we need to say, Hi, Lakshmi Deepak. I'm just putting. Congratulations. Your content has been updated. Congratulations is not a good word. We have a reject also. Your content has been updated to, what is the status? How to get a status? Here we'll say status field we need to keep, right? And okay. then for the following account details records all these are dynamic okay all these fields should be dynamic how to get this dynamic is very simple if you can see here right available merge fields
okay
here we need to select which content Pro Coding Skills content fields. And what is the first field you need? Name field, right? Content name.
Yeah.
Just Control A, Control C, Control V. That's it. You don't want to do so much there. And then we need status, right?
Yeah.
Status. Copy. And then paste. And then what you need? Account details. Account details. These are called merge fields. These are called
merge
fields. And then email sender name. Email sender name. Email sender can get from user details, right?
Yeah.
User. First name. I'll say nickname. I'll go with nickname. Okay.
Okay.
Say. Now I'll say verification. Just for a verification, we can see how data is populating. Send verification related to Pro Coding Skills content and select the record. Input the Lakshmi Deepak and okay. Inukurti Lakshmi Deepak, your content has been updated 2 pending for approval, the following phone number. For the following phone number, type customer director and location. Got it?
Yeah.
Now we have template ready. Then what we need to do? We need to create a workflow. We need to create a workflow. How many types of workflow criteria we have? 3 types.
Yeah.
Created. Every time it got created, or every time created or edited, or subsequently met criteria. In this case, okay. Which criteria we need?
Subsequently met criteria.
Subsequently met criteria. Yes, we can do that. Pro coding skills. But in this case, let's say my status is getting changed. My status is either getting changed from status pending for approval, published or approved or rejected. Any of these status will be changed, right? Yeah. I should not go with subsequently met criteria. I should be showing anything like, let's say, subsequently met criteria, we can choose. Pro coding skills. Where is pro coding skills content? And then next. And rule name is status update notifications. Okay. This will trigger when the status change from change. This will trigger only when status change. In this case, I'll go create and every time it edited, okay?
Yeah.
Here we have two things. Either you can say that criteria are met, formula evaluated true. The same thing as like a validation rules.
Okay.
You don't leave this screen in entire your configurations. It's the same screen that you will be seeing always.
Okay.
So now yeah. I'll say criteria is met. Now I'll say first pro coding skills status. Is changed. There is no is changed, right?
Yeah.
So now I need to go to formula. So some functions is not available. So I'll say and. What is our first condition we need to check? Is changed. What is the field name? Status.
Status.
Check syntax. It's a right practice to check syntax whenever you insert something, not for last time.
Okay.
And then comma. I have certain conditions called or. It should be changed and it should be in the conditions of this one. Status.
Okay.
Text of status. Equal to single quotes, comma, why? I'll just put my block diagram first. So I have three statuses. What is the three statuses here? What is the status?
Approved, published, rejected.
Yes. Approved. Any one of these status should be contained, but status should be changed. Publish. Rejected. Public or rejected. Now I'm checking my condition. You understand this logic, right? How it works now?
Yes.
First it will check status should be back. I mean change. It should change. Either from approved or published or anything to anything. But the final value should be it within these conditions.
Okay.
Right, and then I'm saving and next, and I'm saving and next. Now we need to add a workflow actions here. We need to add a workflow actions. So here I will be adding a new email alert. Here I will be adding a new email alert. Email to status status update to notification to user. Here we need to select our email template, the one we created now.
Yes.
So choose your folder name and then search for your template and then select the template. So you got it? Recipient types, in the sense to whom you need to send. Email to whom you need to send. Here in your case, we need to send to our email field, right?
Yeah.
So in that time, we need to say email field. As soon as you select, it will only select those fields which have email data type, not like an email as a label.
Okay.
The field should be email data type.
Okay.
So I selected email data type and I can provide my additional emails. I'll just provide my address as a CC here. Okay. Yeah. And then I'm saving this. And I'm saving this. Clear? And I'll just open my Gmail parallel. Let it get open. Okay. Now, as soon as you click done after saving that, you need to activate workflow rule by default. You need to activate it. Otherwise, it will not work. Activate.
Yeah.
Okay. You accepted this. Now I'll go and I'll just change the status pending approval to approve. Okay, save.
Okay.
Check it out. You might get an email. Your content has modified, and I can see here also your email ID is also there, right?
Okay.
You got it.
Once. Yes, Deepak, I got it.
And I'm just, what I'm doing, I'm cloning this record. I'm cloning this record. Instead of this, I'll say Nikhil is active and status equal to valid published. And I'm saving this information. You got another email now? You got another email?
Checking it. No, not yet.
No. Got it?
Yes,
the record. Yeah, now the problem. See, now as soon as if I'm creating a record for a first time, right? I'm creating a record for a first time. Still, my system is allowing me to create a status by selecting a status, anything, whatever I wanted, right?
Yeah.
But I need to write a validation rule. It should not allow anything else other than draft for a first time.
Okay.
Other than draft, it should not allow anything else. So, how to write a validation rule? How to write a validation rule?
New,
perfect. Status, validation.
Hey.
So, first, and we have two conditions. Is new, right?
Yeah.
Is new. We have that is new. Which will return for a first time, and then I'll say not of is pick where. What is the pick list name? Status.
Status.
And then not of draft. I don't want to say. If it is not draft, then throw error. Simpler.
Okay.
Field for new contents, always status should be dropped.
Okay.
Status save. Now I'll create a new, then if I select something else, paste, row coding skills, and I'm saving it. It will not.
Okay.
Right? So let's say Lokesh draft, and I'm not making him active, and I'm saving it, okay? Now, one of my account manager, later I realized that by going to my account, I was thinking, okay, there is a requirement from business saying that, Hare, I have too many content objects under this account. I need that number just below number of locations, number of contents.
Okay.
Number of active contents. By showing a simple field called number of active contents, just below number of locations.
Number of locations.
How to get this? As we can't create a formula field because we have multiple number of childs.
Okay.
What is the relationship between account and content object? What is the relationship we have?
Parent.
Parent only, which master detail, right?
Yeah.
In master detail, if you can create a new field here, you can see roll-up summaries. Okay, this is available here. Generally, roll-up summary field you can create only if the objects are in master detail relationships.
Okay.
Now, let me go to object manager. I need to create a field in my account object, right?
Yeah.
Fields and relationship, new, and then roll-up summary. Next, what is the field that I can do now?
Content. Number of contents.
Number of contents. Displaying count for active contents. Only active contents, okay?
Okay.
We have three records, but we have only two active contents. Summarized object, which object we need to summarize? Skills.com content.
Yes.
And then you need just a count, yes, for all records, or you need to mention any criteria?
Just below the number of locations.
No, just below is fine. Do you want to consider all the records from site content related to account, or you have any conditions?
No
we conditions. Have conditions, right? Active should be true.
Okay. Okay.
Is active equals?
Equals true.
True. Insert selected, and then next.
Okay.
Visible to all. Now say, what is the customer requirement? It should come just below number of locations, right?
Yeah.
Now see where it comes. Details. This is number of contents, it's somewhere here.
Okay.
But again, where we need to modify? In page layouts.
Okay.
In page layouts. Here we have multiple, right?
Yeah.
How we'll get to know? By clicking page layout assignments, by clicking page layout assignment, you can go to system administrator, right?
Okay.
What is assigned to you? Account layout. For other people, there is different layouts.
Okay.
You got this screen how I went? Page layout.
Yes.
And then I click page layout assignment.
Page layout assignment. Yes. Edit.
And then system administrator, click on account layout. Now we'll get a right page layout where we need to modify.
Okay.
Where I need to keep number of locations should go just below here.
Yeah.
Save. Now you can see. My goal. details. You got number of locations, right? So what I'll do,
yeah.
I'll just go and update a new another location, Lokesh also to active. Save. And then if I refresh, you will get
same now. Same number of contacts.
We'll get 3, right? So this is called summary field. So this is called roll up summary field. But this field you can able to create only when the objects are in master detail relationship. When the objects are in master detail relationship. You can't create anything else. We can only create a roll up summary field for a master detail records. Number of locations 3. Clear?
Okay.
Let's say here we have like a cost. Here, if we consider that you have a cost field here, but I wanted to know how many active costs, how many contents which is having a total amount, right? As a owner, I should see a final numbers. Okay, Lokesh is saying 10,000 and you are saying 20 and I'm saying 30. What is the total active price list we have for this account? 40,000.
Okay.
Number of locations is 3. And below to this, if I create another roll-up summary field saying that contents pricing. Total contents pricing. So it gives a proper expectation, right? Hey, we have 10 locations, but we are making 5,000. But we have 3, but we are making 40,000. The customers, I mean, the account owners will get a clear picture what account is performing well.
Okay.
Clear?
Yeah.